Welcome to the United States Army Cadet Command Recruiting and Marketing Competition. We are 7220 Consulting, elevating your business. Let me introduce our team. Jackson Dieterding, Emily Bailey, and TJ Thompson. We'll start with the agenda. Who the client is and what they need. The Cowboy Battalion. We'll go over marketing principles, how the battalion can use technology to include research, technology, and media mock-ups. We'll go over financial benefit assessment, the cost, training value, and application of cadet degrees, a summary, and we'll field any questions at the end.
Before we can understand what the Cowboy Battalion's future needs are, we must first take a step back and establish the battalion's history and rich traditions. Developed in 1891, the Cowboy Battalion was one of the first ROTC programs to be formed. As one of the first seven schools in the nation, they identify with other respected programs like Norwich University, the Corps of Cadets at Texas A&M, as well as the Citadel. With the start of World War I, Wyoming Army ROTC officially became an ROTC unit in 1916. Throughout its history, unique traditions have emerged. Traditions like the Bronze Boot Run have formed esprit de corps for both the cadets and the citizens of Wyoming. Since 1968, a bronze boot has been the coveted trophy for the Border War, a football game between the University of Wyoming and Colorado State University. This heated rivalry receives a great deal of media attention, including annual national coverage by ESPN. It's an important tool used to portray a positive image for the battalion. Wyoming Army ROTC has had the pleasure of several distinguished officers graduate from the program. Secretary Les Brownlee, who served as Secretary of the Army from 2001 to 2003, and the 35th Chief of Staff, retired General Pete Schumacher, are a few of the notable alumni. More recently, the Cowboy Battalion was named the most outstanding unit in 2001, and they have consistently had top-performing cadets graduate from the program. The Cowboy Battalion has embraced its history and used it to build leaders for life. In the past 3 years, at least 25% of the graduating MS4 class has been a Distinguished Military Graduate, or DMG. UW Army ROTC has been recognized as one of the top 10 programs in the nation and number one in its region. Success transitions into physical training, where cadets train well over 7,000 feet above sea level. By the time MS3s go off to the Cadet Leader Course, their premier training before becoming an Army officer, they have a PT test average of well over 300 points. Also, at various summer camps, over half of cadets perform well above class standards. And lastly, over 70% of cadets are on scholarship in the program. According to Cadet Command, this is the highest percentage in the entire nation.
Now that we understand who the Cowboy Battalion was from their distinguished past and who the Cowboy Battalion is and their top-tier performance, what they desire is fit, intelligent, involved recruits who are leaders of character and have a propensity for military service. Wyoming Army ROTC program partners with the University of Wyoming to develop leaders of character capable of meeting the total Army challenges of operational adaptability in an era of persistent conflict. They commission officers who can think independently, act decisively, morally, and ethically. The marketing platform for the Cowboy Battalion needs to be low-cost and effective marketing targeted to reach quality recruits. It needs to be user-friendly with remote and low-involvement management. To meet the Cowboy Battalion's needs, our program here at 7220 Consulting went through a research process to determine what makes a quality cadet, the attributes shared by quality cadets, reaching those future recruits with the same qualities, and directing those recruits to the Cowboy Battalion website and media. From our research here, you can see that 58% of high school recruits were multi-sport athletes. 28% of those recruits were single-sport athletes, and only 14% didn't play sports, though they were involved with programs such as FFA, Civil Air Patrol, and student government. To reach our target demographic, we looked up an online survey for our target demographic from 12-year-olds to 29-year-olds. 93% of this target demographic is online. Another thing we looked at was the location of the University of Wyoming. Because of its location near Colorado and Wyoming, it has a large amount of Colorado and Wyoming cadets, though it has a broad outreach across the entire nation. From this graph here, you can see that the entire East Coast, Midwest, and West Coast is covered, including 5 cadets from Alaska. To go over some marketing basics, the 4 P's of marketing are product, place, price, and promotion. Place and promotion will be the most effective mix of principles for the Cowboy Battalion. To use technology to increase their outreach, we understand that 93% of teens are online, this being a cost-effective platform to reach future recruits. Technology and online networking connections are best suited for the Cowboy Battalion's marketing needs. Some of that technology that the Cowboy Battalion can implement needs to be easy to use, making training more effective, and it allows more cadets to be trained. It needs to be accessible for everyone. It needs to be remote with low involvement management. This will enable the Cowboy Battalion to be dynamic and efficient with its use of technology. It won't take away valuable time from recruiters, so they don't need to be monitoring it 24/7. It's a self-sustaining system. To cover some of the costs, because of the relationships with corporate sponsors that the Cowboy Battalion has and fundraising through the program, it will not cost the battalion anything. Some of the equipment supplied by those corporate sponsors is a filming drone. It's a multi-echelon training tool that will improve cadets' training on not only learning how to use the drone, but also filming in more dimensions, such as a top view, side views, to help them understand their movement techniques better, gathering more angles for filming and their promotional videos. Something that the Cowboy Battalion can implement is their media placement on campus. Using the promotional videos that they already have in place in high traffic areas such as the Union, Library, and Gateway Center will help give them the maximum exposure to students who are looking to become a future Army officer. Geofencing is another technology that we suggest to the Cowboy Battalion. A vast majority of students on campus have smartphones with apps, and within those apps, advertisements will pop up. The Cowboy Battalion is taking advantage of something that plays a large role in everyday student life. They will now have, instead of focused on media placement in high traffic areas also, but it will target specific time frames and will give them the highest payout, which will funnel everyone within a 5-mile radius to the battalion Facebook page through advertisements and geofencing. To use social media. The vast majority of students and future recruits have Facebook or some sort of social media. Social media is essentially free and can be reached to a large variety of future recruits. The Cowboy Battalion being active on Facebook has an effective means of recruiting and marketing in terms of cost and time management. On Facebook, they can put up pictures, events, cadet achievements, and it can be shared and seen with a vast majority of people. The website is the bread and butter of the Cowboy Battalion. Because the university owns the domain name, it doesn't cost the battalion anything. It has essential information on the website for the programs that they have to offer. It has profiles on cadre members, parent guides to address questions and fears that parents might have, as well as cadet resources that will help the cadet in transitioning from a civilian high schooler to a U.S. Army cadet. As stated earlier, the videos are promotional videos of cadets, by cadets, and for future prospects. Links to the video are on email, YouTube, Facebook, and the website. We would also like the Cowboy Battalion to implement media placement on campus in those high traffic areas like we spoke about. Recruiting tables is also something that the Cowboy Battalion can expand upon, allowing cadets and cadre to talk to future recruits face-to-face. It would give them a visual representation of what people would expect when joining the program. Another platform is email. Funneling to the website is important, and email is a big key to this. That is because the link in the video and the websites are attached to all the cadre signatures. This is a constant communication platform between cadre and prospects. Social media and the battalion websites have a funneling effect, like we've spoken about, meaning everything posted on Facebook or within emails will funnel them to the battalion website. Here's an example of the battalion social media and the battalion website. The website has lots of links and info in it, important events and articles about the battalion. The school magazine is included in the Cowboy Battalion website, which is focused on the front page of the magazine with several articles that benefit the program and grants. There's scholarship information, pictures, and contact information for cadre members and more. The Cowboy Battalion promotional videos are a key tool used here at the battalion. Here's an example of the Cowboy Battalion video that is one of their multiple promotional videos of cadets, by cadets, and for prospects.
Welcome to Wyoming, an unyielding, untamed, and unforgiving environment. This is the frontier. Harsh and formidable.
Now, another thing that must be considered is the cost. In the Cowboy Battalion, success breeds success. This has been seen in how they've created a relatively no-cost operation. This has been done through fundraising by cadets, as well as creating positive relationships with corporate sponsors. These sponsors see the success of cadets and want to help continue that. Now, from the years 2000 to 2012, they were only commissioning an average of 8 cadets a year. And from the years 2013 to 2015, they began commissioning an average of 20-plus cadets a year. This means they've nearly tripled the amount of commissionees in 3 years. The Cowboy Battalion was able to do this through multi-echelon training done through battalion staff positions that lead to a well-rounded leader. Most college market youth do not see the military as offering careers that align with their values, but the battalion has been able to give them work positions that pertain to their degree field, which provides on-the-job training that applies to both the civilian and military life. They must also consider the brand. The Wyoming ROTC program has established the brand as the Cowboy Battalion. Now we must help them expand this. They've already begun to use clothing. They have created special PT uniforms that they wear on Fridays, as well as different t-shirts that they use for special teams. They've also begun placing banners and murals focused on the cadets around campus in high traffic areas. These create a positive association with the battalion. And about a third of college market youth are unaware of the path to becoming a military officer, and this can help provide them with direction or spark an interest in going to talk to a cadre member or another cadet. They can also build relationships with different departments on campus and other highly influential organizations in the community. An example is how they've already begun to work with the athletic department. They have begun to have a positive presence through canning crew, raising and lowering field goal nets, push-up board, and color guard at the games. They can also continue a relationship that they have created with a posse club. The posse club is a partnership between cadets and civilians that conduct weekly meetings and training that specialize in search and rescue. And a few examples of this is a few years ago they helped find a downed airplane in the area, as well as attending shoot houses with the local law enforcement. It is important for the battalion to continue to create strong relationships with different community organizations to have a positive association with the ROTC program.
Again, another one of the great promotional videos that's done here at the University of Wyoming Army ROTC. To summarize, the Cowboy Battalion can use data from our research here at 7220 Consulting to target specific attributes shared by quality cadets and utilize social media and other technologies to further their outreach and branding. By continuing fundraising and their corporate relationships, Wyoming Army ROTC can maintain a no-cost marketing platform to further their recruiting and expand the size and quality of their battalion. We'll go ahead and field any questions at this time.
Well, you're talking about the target demographic and the quality cadet that we should be after. What is the average GPA of that market?
So here our team has put together a packet that will be distributed to you and all other members in this brief following the conclusion of this presentation. But what we found in our research that the average high school GPA for a quality recruit here at the University of Wyoming will be about a 3.6 GPA.
Okay. In that same quality market, what's the average SAT?
We have found the average SAT score to be an 1140.
So now the Cowboy Battalion can utilize these stats by looking at future oncoming recruits, and if they fall within your target demographic, such as a 3.6 GPA and 1170 SAT score, that is something that you can help determine whether this would be a quality or non-quality cadet to help further improve your program.
Okay, with the focus command-wide on STEM, what is the percentage of STEM in that same market?
In that market, there was roughly 30% STEM majors.
Perfect.
Are there any other questions?
No. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We're 7220, and we appreciate your time.